Hello everyone, myself Dr. Jalpa Dave, Clinical Associate in Paediatric Nephrology at SRCC Children's Hospital, Mumbai. And today we have Dr. Uma Ali, Senior Consultant, Paediatric Nephrologist and Head of Division of Paediatric Nephrology at SRCC Children's Hospital, Mumbai. Continuing our session, we are going to discuss today regarding urinary tract infection in children. So, ma'am, what is urinary tract infection per se? And how common it is in children?
Yeah. Urinary tract infections are quite common in children. One could say it's perhaps the third most common infection after diarrhea, respiratory tract infection, chest infections. It would be the third most common infection in children. Okay. So it generally means somewhere along the urinary tract, you know, the kidneys or the bladder which stores the urine, there is an infection, and that is visible in the urine on testing.
Okay, ma'am. So, ma'am, what are the symptoms children may come when they have urinary tract infection, and how they differ from those symptoms which we usually see in adult population?
Children generally, the most common way children present for urinary tract infection is high fever. So, the fever is high, maybe more than 102, 103. With feeling of cold, shivering, there may also be vomiting sometimes, and sometimes maybe pain in the stomach or back. These are the common symptoms, and often these fevers are mistaken for viral fevers. But it's important to remember that when a fever comes without any other focus, that means there's fever, but there's no cold, there's no cough, there's no diarrhea, then one should keep in mind that this may be a urinary tract infection, and so should always test the urine before taking antibiotics so that we know what is the infection the child has had. In older children, it may present with just burning while passing urine, or passing urine very frequently, every 10 minutes or 30 minutes, child wants to go and pass a small amount of urine, and that has a lot of burning sensation when the child passes urine. And in very small babies who are just newborns or few months old, the symptoms may be very, very vague. So they may just not take feeds well, may vomit, or may be little dull, lethargic. So these are features of any infection, and also these will be the features of urinary infection in smaller children.
Why it is important to pick up this urinary tract infection on earlier basis and treat them as soon as we came to know that the child is having urinary tract infections?
Yeah. Urinary tract infections in children is very different from urinary tract infections in adults. When we don't expect children to get urinary tract infections. So when the child gets a urinary tract infection, especially if it's a younger child below 5 years of age, there's a strong chance that there is something underlying which is abnormal. So something present from birth in the development of the kidney, urinary tract, bladder, which may not have developed in the right way, and that is causing problems and putting the child at risk for infection. So we can never take a urinary tract infection in a child lightly. We need to treat it immediately and treat it well so that the infection does not cause damage to the kidney. So any urinary tract infection, if severe enough, can harm the kidney and produce scars in the kidney, which can lead to long-term problems. So urinary tract infection in children has to be taken seriously. It can be treated very easily, but it may reflect that there is a serious problem underneath. So even after the child is well, the child may need to be tested, especially with a sonography, to see if the underlying kidney is normal or is there anything abnormal which we need to further investigate. For these reasons, we need to recognize them early, not miss the diagnosis, test the urine before taking antibiotics, and if it's a urinary tract infection, then search for a cause of why this child has a urinary tract infection, especially if the child is a young child or is a boy.
Ma'am, are there any measures with the help of which we can prevent the occurrence of urinary tract infections, or are there any factors which increase the propensity to get a urinary tract infection in children?
I think we have to look at urinary tract infection into very clear aspects. That first, is there something underneath, underlying an abnormality which is making the child prone to infections? In which case that has to be diagnosed properly and treated appropriately. So they would need specialized care from a pediatric nephrologist or a pediatric surgeon depending on the underlying problem that's discovered. So that needs to be addressed. In older children, especially girls, many times the urinary tract infections develop because they do not go to the toilet regularly to pass the urine. Throughout the time they are in school, they don't go and pass urine at all because they feel the school toilets are not clean. And as a result of holding back the urine and not wanting to pass, they also take less water. So both these together increases the risk of urinary tract infection. So to prevent urinary tract infections, one, there should be a good amount of water intake. So for a school going child, in the Indian climate, it would be at least 2 liters of water which the child has to take. So when the child is at school, probably since they are about 6 to 8 hours in school, they should finish drinking at least 1 liter of water while they are in school. Second, they need to use the school toilet to pass urine and not wait till they come home to pass urine, which is very common in girl children because they don't want to use the school toilet. The reason they don't want to use the school toilet is either the lock is broken in the toilet or the toilets are not clean. So it's very important that parents and teachers in the PTA meeting make this an important issue, that school toilets, especially for girls, are maintained clean, that there should be a safety latch, there should be a female attendant who can guide them, clean them. And it's important for parents also to teach their children how to use the toilet hygienically and leave it clean. And that should be re-emphasized in school. It should be part of school's kind of initiation of a child when the child enters school, how to use the school facilities, how do you use the drinking water, how do you use the toilet. These are simple things which children should be taught, and the attendant should be responsible for maintaining it clean. Unless all schools take this initiative, it would be very difficult to prevent urinary tract infection. A third thing which is important is to avoid constipation. Constipation is an extremely common problem, and the child may not be passing stools daily or passing very hard stools. And all this comes from one, very poor water intake, and second, a very bad diet. Today, most children eat a lot of junk foods which serve as substitutes for regular food. So the food does not have fiber. It has high refined flour, high fat, which are all constipate the child. So normal healthy diet, breakfast, lunch, dinner, with good fiber, vegetables, fruits, with lots of water, about 2 liters at least for a school going child. And passing urine once in at least 3 hours is very important to prevent urinary tract infection.
Ma'am, as they say that once we treat UTI, it's not over. And you also mentioned that we need to follow up also these children after the first episode of urinary tract infection, which we say is UTI. So why is it different from the other respiratory infection? Why we need to follow up them afterwards also?
I think the most important thing in urinary tract infection is that it can leave behind some long-term ill effects. So a bad infection can harm the kidney and leave behind scars in the kidney when it is healing. So repeated urinary infection can lead to multiple scars in the kidney. And this can have, even though the infection is gone, the scars might remain. And this can have an impact later on in life, either in childhood itself or as young adults. It can lead to high blood pressure, and in a very bad case where both kidneys are scarred, it can even lead to kidney failure. So in fact, urinary tract infection is an important cause, a repeated urinary tract infection, which can lead to renal failure or kidney failure in later life. So it's very important to diagnose it early, treat it adequately, identify if there are risk factors, treat those, and put in all the measures needed to prevent a second urinary tract infection.
So in nutshell, as Madam has rightly said, that we should not even take a single episode of urinary tract infection, especially in younger children, lightly. And it's not a part of only a doctor to treat it, but it's also equal part a parent should play, that they should make sure regarding the diet habits of children, which should be adequate, as well as they should make sure that the children are using the toilets in school properly, so that they don't develop the their bowel bladder habit should be maintained accordingly. Thank you so much, ma'am, for enlightening us on the urinary tract infection. Thank you.
Thank you.